to St. John's Episcopal Church in Hampton, Virginia for our online worship of morning prayer this Sunday. We are so glad you could join us whenever you are watching this. We hope live, but we will begin our service with our opening words. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ.
The Lord is faithful in all his words,
and merciful in all his deeds. The Lord upholds all those who fall. He lifts up those who are bowed down. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
A reading from the letter of Paul to the Romans. I do not understand my own actions, for I do not do what I want, but I do the very thing I hate. Now, if I do what I do not want, I agree that the law is good. But in fact, it is no longer I that do it, but sin that dwells within me. For I know that nothing good dwells within me, that is, in my flesh. I can will what is right, but I cannot do it. For I do not do the good I want, but the evil I do not want is what I do. Now, if I do what I do not want, it is no longer I that do it, but sin that dwells within me. So I find it to be a law that when I want to do what is good, evil lies close at hand. For I delight in the law of God, in my inmost self, but I see in my members another law, at war with the law of my mind, making me captive to the law of sin that dwells in my members. Wretched man that I am, who will rescue me from this body of death? Thanks be to God through Jesus Christ our Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Calling to one another. We played the flute for you, and you did not dance. We wailed, and you did not mourn. For John came neither eating nor drinking. And they say, he has a demon. The Son of Man came eating and drinking, and they say, look, a glutton and a drunkard, a friend of tax collectors and sinners. Yet wisdom is vindicated by her deeds. At that time, Jesus said, I thank you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, because you have hidden these things from the wise and the intelligent, and you have revealed them to infants. Yes, Father, for such was your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father, and no one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and to anyone to whom the Son chooses to reveal him. Come to me, all you that are weary and are carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. I speak to you in the name of one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. In one individual portion or pericope of the gospel, we see Jesus go from a harsh rebuke to one of the more memorable and loving teachings of his entire ministry. He begins with a question that reminds me of a Shakespearean sonnet. Shall I compare thee to a summer's day? We know that Jesus often compares humankind to children in order to explain how to approach and love God. We should act like innocent, sweet little children who love God as a father. Our connection should be personal, not formal. So instead of father, maybe more like Abba, or Papa, or Daddy. God is or should be seen as loving, caring, and a protective parent. Sadly, the description here is not as lovely as the sonnet, and Jesus uses this image of children that are far from cherubic or sweet. More along the lines of petulant, bratty children screaming at one another across a crowded marketplace. He creates more of an image of children who were not playing well together, you might say. In this brief description, Jesus manages to capture the actions of child's play, acting in a marketplace, and copying the roles they would have seen there at that time. Then as now, kids were play acting. Except instead of mirroring a TV show or a movie, they were watching the entertainment all around them going on in their times in this marketplace. They were modeling what was around them like celebration parades with music and dancing, or what was often the case, a funeral procession. Like our modern day vehicle processions, when the processions would pass by, people would pause, or like we do, pull to the side to respect those who were in mourning. In this era, it was even customary to have what were known as professional wailers. Just to be clear, they're not members of a reggae band. These people were basically actors who were paid to wail and cry loudly so everyone would know that they were coming and could mourn whoever came past. As is often the case now, the larger the gathering, the more influential or more important the person was in that society. As I noted, these children were arguing and complaining with one another. They were acting selfish, self-centered. They each wanted their own way, and they wouldn't yield to the other. Jesus was sadly not telling us about children playing. He was pointing out how these children mirror the adults who influence them. And the children reflected more than just the actions, but also the attitudes toward God and toward one another. He goes on to use a second example, driving his point a little further. Just like the children being at odds with each other. Seemed like the way both he and John were received. The children expected one thing, dancing, and they didn't get it. They got the opposite. John lived an austere life, literally eating to live, not living to eat. It was simply nourishment. And people saw that as bad, negative. He must have some kind of demon. He's not normal. Then Jesus comes along and he eats and drinks just like everybody else in society. But instead of being what would be normal, he was considered a glutton, a drunkard. You can't expect dancing or mourning, and you're either starving, possessed, living in excess, and spending time with all the wrong people. Nothing was ever good enough to please this generation. They had all the answers for what was wrong. Not necessarily, though, for what was right. Too much or too little, just not quite right. They realized that it was easier to not commit to what was right, just in case they got it wrong. And they were struggling. This passage we have today from Paul in Romans seems to sum this up both by what he was saying and by the way he actually expressed it. Paul uses words to create verbal loop-de-loops or some kind of mental quicksand. It is said that when you're slipping into quicksand, the more you move, the further you'll sink. And that in order to stop sinking, especially stop sinking quickly, you have to stop moving. Which, when you're sinking, goes against every bit of what your mind is telling you. Paul is thrashing around this idea for all he's worth. And he's still sinking. He sinks up to the very last line, which says, "Who will rescue me from this body of death? Thanks be to God through Jesus Christ our Lord." Jesus pointed out that all the mental or physical thrashing about for what the people thought was right or right to do was still only a guess. The love and wisdom of God was not hard to grasp or understand, and anyone, even little children, could understand it. The hard part, the tough part, was actually being able to love like God loved and still loves. It's easy to understand, and one of the hardest things to do consistently. Jesus knew it, and that's why he took the time to teach and model God's love. He knew that the burden of being faithful was not easy, and that burden would bear down on us. And when we start sinking, what do? We do, or should do, what doesn't come naturally. Stop thrashing about and rest. When we start thinking, we do what doesn't come naturally. Stop thrashing and rest. We have to broaden our view and begin to trust, really, that God's with us. We aren't sinking. And then we start to realize when we rest, we're holding in place. Now we can see what's going on around us and slowly begin to realize that the simplicity of loving and caring for our family means so much more than anything else could possibly mean. The yoke is lighter, as Jesus said, because we know what is most important, love. Once we know that love, we can begin to move out from the mire. See past the danger. We rest in knowing that our work to love and care for family can grow out to extended family, and then friends, and then neighbors. We can rest in that. Seek that love for ourselves and for others. For whatever reason, the troubles of this world have stirred up more than just a simple virus and pandemic. We are thrashing and struggling about, and it seems at times like the quicksand is getting the better of us. The harder we try, the further we sink. So what do? We rest. We stop. Maybe even repeat that verse from Romans. Who will rescue me from this body of death? Thanks be to God through Jesus Christ, our Lord. The one who tells us my yoke is easy and my burden is light tells us to rest in him. Stop. Rest. Repeat Romans if you need to. Rest again. Begin to find and show love. Stop thrashing. Love our neighbor. Rest. Romans. Repeat. Love. Rest. Romans if needed. Repeat. Amen.
We will continue with the Apostles' Creed. Together.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Show us your mercy, O Lord.
And grant us your salvation.
Clothe your ministers with righteousness.
Let your people sing with joy.
Give peace, O Lord, in all the world.
For only in you can we live in safety.
Lord, keep this nation under your care.
And guide us in the way of justice and truth.
Let your way be known upon earth.
Your saving health among all nations.
Let not the needy, O Lord, be forgotten.
Nor the hope of the poor be taken away.
Create in us clean hearts, O God.
And sustain us with your Holy Spirit.
O God, you have taught us to keep all your commandments by loving you and our neighbor. Grant us the grace of your Holy Spirit that we may be devoted to you with our whole heart and united to one another with pure affection. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
O God, you make us glad with the weekly remembrance of the glorious resurrection of your Son, our Lord. Give us this day such blessing through our worship of you, that the week to come may be spent in your favor through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Now let us pray together a prayer for our times. Loving God,
your desire is for our wholeness and well-being. We hold in tenderness and prayer the collective suffering of our world at this time. We grieve precious lives lost and vulnerable lives threatened. We ache for ourselves and for our neighbors, standing before an uncertain future. We pray may love not fear go viral. Inspire our leaders to discern and choose wisely, aligned with the common good. Help us to practice social distancing and reveal to us new and creative ways to come together in spirit and in solidarity. Call us to profound trust in your faithful presence, you, the God who does not abandon.
Heavenly Father, in you we live and move and have our being. We humbly pray you so to guide and govern us by your Holy Spirit, that in all the cares and occupations of your life we may not forget you, but we may remember that we are ever walking in your sight through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Almighty and everlasting God, by whose Spirit the whole body of your faithful people is governed and sanctified, receive our supplications and prayers which we offer before you for all members of your holy church, that in their vocation and ministry they may truly and devoutly serve you, through our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
Amen. And now at this point, we pause to offer prayers, intercessions, and thanksgivings for all those who are on our hearts or on our lips. We pray especially for all those who are on our prayer list here at St. John's, our whole St. John's family, our community, the nation, and the world. We give thanksgivings for the birthdays and anniversaries celebrated this week, and we continue to lift up all those who are doing their absolute utmost for those who are suffering through sickness, homelessness, fear, anxiety, depression, all those things we lift up now. And now I'd ask that you join me in our prayer. Dear Lord, help us to follow your example by looking out for those who each day feel that they are marginalized, who cannot find help, who believe that they have little to offer, who are overcome by the challenges of poverty. Help us to widen our horizons, to make space for the stranger, to watch out for those who feel invisible, to give time to the outsider, to talk to the person facing silence, to restore justice and value. Give us the courage to undertake this, the determination to join with others in seeing grace in every human face, and the faith to embrace the opportunity in your name. Amen.
Let us continue with the great general thanksgiving. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for your immeasurable love in the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts, we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service, and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom, with you and the Holy Spirit, be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplication to you. And you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will be in the midst of them. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth and in the age to come, life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Yeah.
and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen.
Amen. Wait, and I would like to remind you that you may still give online using our online giving, which you can find on our website, or going directly to Tithely using the website that's listed. Thank you.